Hi everyone and welcome back. And here we are writing this auth gateway service, and the objective of this service is talk to Firebase and just say, okay, this token is valid or this token is invalid. So there are different kind of solutions available. Obviously Firebase provides us a method using which we can validate, okay, this token is respective to this particular audience or auth key or private key. If yes, then it will return true. So sometimes what we want, we also want to manage the state of the service across different microservices. Like once user is logged into the Firebase and we are just sending the token, okay, this token, this gatekeeper service will just say, okay, yes, token is valid, and you go ahead with your each and every request. Sometimes we also need to maintain the state of user. What I mean to say is, sometimes we want to get the user data directly instead of decoding the token or going to this auth gateway service for a particular endpoint to get a user data. In that particular case, what we can do is we can use Redis. The only advantage of using Redis here is you can actually store the user metadata in Redis whenever user is coming in. Okay, so there is a login request, validate request is coming. You just keep always updating it. And whenever from the front end you are doing logout, then also trigger the logout service and clear out the data from the Redis. So there are only specific use case where you want to Redis on this particular service is used to just store the key value data about user, like user data, colon, email ID. This can be your Redis key, and you have all the user data, user auth ID, user ID, all the data about the user, at least the metadata. So any particular service can go and talk to Redis to get more information about the user instead of we pass on this information in the token, right? We can't store a lot of information in the JWT token, decoded token. So few things we can store in the metadata, but here we are violating the principle of stateless token. Currently this token is stateless because every time you will get a new token and it will just validate it. Here now we are maintaining the state of a token, right? Because we are storing the corresponding token and its values for the user metadata. So that there can be a particular use case where you want to store the state of user session, which is token based, because JWT is stateless. It is not storing any state. Every time the new token is coming, you are validating it and you are returning the true or false. Okay. So this particular service is not going to have any connection with the database or anything. It's just going to have some initialization of the Firebase, because we are going to use the Firebase SDK for it. Okay. And we already know that at the client side, we did the Firebase integration. Now at the server side to validate it. So this is kind of common. At the client side, we do the integration with Auth0, and also to validate the token, we write the gatekeeper service or some kind of a Lambda on the API gateway to validate that token coming from the client is valid or not. Similarly, that same thing we are doing with the Firebase. Okay, so this auth gateway is nothing but it is going to have a simple basic boilerplate code we have, right? It's just another microservice, we can say. Okay, it has a same kind of package.json where we are going to write npm run start dev. It will just start this. So first we will try to understand what we need to have in this particular service. Just a simple authenticate endpoint that will just check your headers, authorization token, and will just say return. It will just return you the user data. That user data can be user auth ID and whatever the information is available in the token. I mean, you can decode the token without even verifying it. So first we will verify, okay, this is the right entity, and then we will decode it and we will return the data. So that is what this particular service is doing. We can build it, but like for each and every microservice, we can't write this middleware for each and every microservice. So we thought of putting it as a single service. So every request first will validate it here, and then it will go to the rest endpoints. Okay, so what we can do is we can write our controllers, like auth controller. We can write, and what this auth controller will contain, this auth controller will have some kind of authenticate endpoint that will validate the token from the authorization header. Before that, the important part about integration is initializing the Firebase SDK. Okay, so this is what you need to do. You have to first get the admin from the Firebase admin, step one. Step two is you have to initialize the app. You have to pass all the credentials, and yes, I will say that you will struggle. I mean, I have also struggled while setting this up. I mean, you might not be able to pass the correct environment variables. So first, always remember admin.initialize app, and in these credentials, you will be passing the private key, client email, project ID, and the database URL. So if your Firebase is initialized properly, that means you have set up the connection properly. These private key, client email, and project ID you can get from your Firebase console for that app which you have created. Okay, so all these things will be your credentials, and the second argument is a database URL. So these two arguments you have to pass. Important thing, once Firebase initialization is done, now I can actually access the Firebase methods. Like there is a, if you look into the Firebase documentation and the server side how to validate the token, there is a dot verify method which takes some client and your token, and it will validate it. Okay, that we will write in the our auth controller. Okay, so let's write auth controller. Here in the auth controller there are a lot of things we are going to write, and we are also going to write services. So in the app we can create services. Okay, in services let's call it as a one service, we can call it as an auth service or Firebase service. Firebase service.ts, and if you want to implement the Redis also as a cache module, you can do. For now you want to make it simple. So auth controller. Now we understood all the tags which we need to expose for the Swagger and all these things. So now things will be easy for us to write auth controller. This is our auth controller, and you might have seen in the API docs there is a authorization button, right? So that authorization, what does that mean? So in which particular key we are sending the token, right? That is being decided from there. So there are two things we have to do. We go to the Swagger module, right? And Swagger service. And there we will define, okay, where we going to receive that token. Okay, so this is important part to notice. So here we specify access token. Okay, let's convert it into authorization. So what this means to say is, whenever you start this service, this Swagger doc will be published. So Swagger doc will consider authorization as a key in which you will pass this bearer token, right? And same we need to pass in our APIs. Authorization, here we need to pass the same thing in our controller on the top, that these controllers, this particular controller is accepting this authorization as a header. So this header is authorization, and the API tags and all, we can just import respective tags. Okay, just wait a second, let's we'll import them later. So this is controller, and controller is saying API v1. So now we can create a API v1 auth method, right? Let's remove all these things. We have constructor, there we will do the dependency injection later once we have the services ready. And here we will define our endpoints. Okay, so there is a simple endpoint is a get authenticate. Authenticate is endpoint. We'll define all the Swagger tags, okay, which will expose these APIs, and our API is simply public async authenticate. This is our method name. This authenticate method is taking request as an argument. So this is how you pass use the request tag in SCS. This is of type request, which can come from Express, and this is returning promise of any. Okay, now what this method will do? Let's import all these things. Okay, let me do npm install. That's why it is not importing anything. That will happen in the background. Okay, now what all we need to make sure here, this is the request and this is the API we want authenticate. Finally, it will become API we want authenticate, and in the authorization header, you will pass the token, right? So const auth token equal to, we got the access of request, right? Request.headers dot authorization. Here we will get the token. If now our condition will start here, if we don't have auth token, right, what we can do is throw a new bad request, because this is what is expected. Bad request exception, and you can just say we already have defined some constant, I think, so we can use them, constant from constant.api. Here I think we have some constants, we can use them for invalid token and all. So let's import them, and here we can just say constant dot you can say invalid auth provider, invalid auth token, missing auth header, right? This is what we need to do, and this is throw, some typo, throw new bad request exception, right? And it is complaining because this is not able to find this request. Let's wait for npm install to be done, right? So this is our express, the request is instance of express, and here we do have authorization. Now, if we have everything, what we will do is let's put everything in the try catch. So, because we are going to use Firebase for this. Okay. Here we will make a call to a particular service. Let's say await this dot auth service dot authenticate. And we'll pass that auth token there. That is what we have. And we will inject this particular service inside a constructor, right? So private read only auth service. That we will import once we have it. Now let's see if we can import few things. No quick fix available. That is fine. So we will also return few things which we are getting from here. If we are getting any error, then throw error. Okay, so this is our API look like. We'll just format this and let's see if we have node modules available here inside the gatekeeper service. Where did I install gateway? Not in the gatekeeper, that's the problem. That's why we are still not able to import. I just need to go inside the correct folder and do npm install. Okay, I will do this, and then we can connect in next video. Okay, so this is our app controller. This is what we have written. Auth controller. This auth controller will talk to the auth service. Auth service will do the integration with the Firebase method. And here we will be able to send the required payload to in the response, like user auth ID once the token is valid. Okay. Thanks everyone.